Okay, good afternoon to one and all. This is Gopi Krishna, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering from Chebrol Engineering College. So, subject is compiler design. And today, we are going to discuss another example of CLR parser. Okay, so in previous class, we are discussing example of CLR parser. Then we want to see one more example, how to understand how to construct the parsing table and how to pass the input string and how to calculate the canonical LR of one item. Okay, so this is we are going to discuss today. Next. Okay, so here is the example. So we have to construct a canonical LR parser for the given grammar. That grammar is S is production with L is equals to capital R, R capital R, and L is production with star capital R, R ID, and R is production with L, and also pass the input string is ID equals to ID. So we have to construct the canonical LR of canonical LR of zero items, LR of one items in this CLR parser. What is LR of one? So it is equal to the LR of zero plus look ahead. Okay, so we have to calculate the LR of one items for this CLR parser. Okay, so in this grammar we have to find the given grammar. We have to find, we have four steps. First one is we have to find the augmented grammar, and second one is the calculate the collection of LR of one item, and third one construction of CLR parsing table, and the fourth one is parse the input string. So these are the steps we have to follow and calculate the CLR parsing table and how to parse the input string. Okay, so these steps we have to follow then calculating the CLR parser. Okay, so first we have to write the augmented grammar. So what is augmented grammar? We have to add one production to that particular given grammar, that becomes the augmented grammar. So augmented, when the grammar is said to be augmented grammar, we have to add one production. So that production is so we are having the starting symbol. For example, starting symbol is A, then we have to add the production. A dash is production with capital A, that is the added production. So here in this grammar we are having the product, we are having the starting symbol capital S. So then the augmented grammar, we are adding the production is S dash is production with capital S, right? And and we are writing the remaining grammar as is. So those are S is production with L is equals to R, and S is production with capital R, and then L is production with star R, and L is production with ID, and capital R is production with capital L. So this grammar is called the this grammar is called augmented grammar. Okay. Narsimha Chopra, hello, hello. Okay, so this is the augmented grammar for the given grammar. Okay, so
the
then
screen kanapadtadu
ippudu
green color vachindi paper meda
ippudu kuda kanipetledha
aha led sir.
ఇప్పుడమ్మా
ఓకే సార్ ఓకే కనపడుతుంది.
సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద step 1. So we are find out the augmented grammar for the given grammar. So augmented grammar, ichina grammar ki augmented grammar rayalante, so we have to add one more production, that is the starting symbol dash production to starting symbol, that is the augmented grammar. Okay, so then first step is completed. What is the second step? We have to calculate the LR of one item. So what is called item? Item is a, so we are having the production, we are specifying the dot, we are specifying dot at the right end, right beginning of the terminal or non-terminal, that is called the item. For example, so what is item means, so we are giving S dash is production with dot S, so this is called a one item. So in this step we have to calculate the LR of one item. So how to calculate the LR of one item? So here we are calculating the LR of one item. So here, so S dash is production with dot S. Okay, so what is the difference between SLR and CLR? So the difference between SLR and CLR, so in SLR parsing technique, we have to calculate the LR of zero item. So in CLR parsing technique, we have to calculate the LR of one item. So LR of one means LR of zero plus look ahead. So how to find the look ahead? In previous class we are discussing how to find the look ahead. Once again we have to calculate how to find the look ahead. Okay, for example, so in this production, S dash is production with dot S, so this production becomes it item. Okay, this production becomes item. Then how to find the look ahead? So in this first production of the augmented grammar, the look ahead is always dollar. Okay, so already cheppanu first previous class lo. So here first production edaithe undo daniki look ahead vachesarki dollar untundi. Okay, so here S dash is production with dot S, then after dot we have a non terminal capital S, then we have to add the, we are using the closure function, so we have to add the production of capital S. So how many productions are available in this capital S? So we are two productions with the starting with the non terminal capital S, then add those two productions here. So S is production with dot L is equals to R comma, and S is production with dot R. Okay, so we are writing these two production. After the dot we have a non terminal capital S, then add the productions of capital S. So then how to find the look ahead? So we have to calculate the look ahead of S. So we are considering this production. So here we are considering this production, S dash is production with dot S. So after the dot we have a non terminal capital S, then we are adding the productions of capital S. So after S there is no terminal or no non terminal, then we are considering as a epsilon. Okay, epsilon into dollar. So S is production with dot S into epsilon comma dollar. So we have to find the first half this one. So we have to find first half this one. So first half epsilon into dollar. So we are having the concatenation, epsilon into dollar becomes dollar, then first half dollar is equals to dollar. Okay, so how to find the first half terminal? So first half terminal is equals to the terminal, is okay. So here the first half terminal dollar, then the first half terminal becomes the terminal, then we are adding dollar onto these two productions. Okay, then we are considering after the dot we have a non terminal, after the dot we have a non terminal capital L, we have a non terminal capital L, then add the productions of L here. So we are adding the productions of L. So what are the productions of L? So L is production with one minute. L is production with dot star R, and L is production with dot ID. So L is production with dot star R and L is production with dot ID. So we are writing the L production. Then we have to calculate the look ahead of this production. So L ki manaki look ahead find out cheyal kabatti. So we are considering this production. So we are considering this one. S is production with dot L equals to R comma dot. So we are taking this one and we are calculating the look ahead for this L. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital L, then include the two productions of L, then we have to calculate the look ahead. So after L we are having equal R and dollar. Okay, so the first half equal into R into dollar. So the first half equal, so equal is a terminal, then the first half equal R dollar is becomes equal. Okay, it becomes equal, then we are including equal onto these two productions. Then what is dollar means? So next chapter chudandi. So L ayipoyindi, equal is the look ahead of these two productions. So here we are considering the production S is produced with dot R. So after the dot we are having capital R. After that we are having capital R. After that we are having a non-terminal capital R. Then include the production of capital R. So R is production with dot L. R is production with dot L. So then we have to calculate the look ahead of this one. So we are considering this statement. So S is production with dot R. After the dot R, then we are including the production. And after R, we are not having any terminal or non-terminal. Then the first half epsilon into dollar. So that becomes concatenated first half dollar, that equals to dollar. Then you add the production of dollar. Here after the dot we have a non-terminal capital L. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital L. So then include the productions of capital L. Then include the productions of capital L. So we are including already L production, but how to calculate the look ahead? So we are considering this one. We are considering this one. Then we have to calculate the first, we have to calculate the look ahead of this one. So after the dot we are a non-terminal capital L, then include the production. And here we are having the after L there is no terminal or non-terminal. Then the first half epsilon into dollar becomes dollar. Then you then add dollar on this look ahead of this production. So is there any doubt, amma? So ikkada equal to tarvata dollars ni place chesam. Adi ela vachindante we are using this production also. Why? Because so after the dot we have a non-terminal capital L. So here also after the dot we have a non-terminal capital L. Then you add the productions of L, and this production is becomes the look ahead is equal, and we are considering this production, we are having the look ahead dollar. Then you add these two look aheads to the non-terminal capital L. Okay, is there any doubt with this one? Anyone? No doubt. So then these productions are considering as a state I naught. These productions are considering as a I naught state. So then we have to calculate the go to function. So we are applying the go to function. The dot is moving one position to the right. So we are applying the go to function on I naught. We are applying go to function on I naught. Then so go to off. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital S. So is there any productions after the dot we have a non-terminal S? So only one production after the dot we have a non-terminal capital S. So we are applying go to function on capital S. Then go to off I naught comma capital S. So we are applying the go to function on this one. So this dot is moving one position to the right. Okay, So then S dash is production with S dot, and we are adding the look ahead as it is. We are adding this look ahead as it is onto the production. Then this production is named as the state I1, is named as the state I1. Then we are applying the go to function on, after the dot we are having the non-terminal capital L. So is there any production with after the dot capital L? So we are one more production here after the dot capital L. Then these two productions we are applying the go to function. Then so this production we are applying the go to function on this. So this dot is moving one position to the right. So we are applying S is production with L dot equal R comma, this dollar is written, look ahead is written as it is. So there is no change of look ahead for this one. Okay, so we are writing dollar. So here after the dot we have a terminal. So there is no productions with this terminal. So no need to include the productions of equal. Okay, so there is no production, then no need to include the production. Then this is one production, and after the dot we have another production, non-terminal L. So we are applying the go to function of this one. So we are applying R is production with, so we are applying go to function, this dot is moving one position to the right. Then the production becomes capital R production with all L dot comma dollar. So we are having the look ahead, there is no change in the look ahead. So this two productions is named as a state I2. So is there any, is these two productions is having any state? So there is no productions in this production. So we have to name the state I2. Okay, then we are applying after the dot we have a non-terminal L completed, and after the dot we have a non-terminal capital R. Then we are applying the go to function on this one. Okay, so go to of I0 comma capital R, then this dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes S produces R dot comma dollar. Why? Because so dollar is the look ahead, we have to write as it is onto the right. So then I2 state is completed, then I3 is the state, new state we are naming, the I3 is the state. So I3 is the new state. Then we are applying after the dot we are having the capital R. Then after the dot we have a terminal star. So we are applying the go to function on this one. So then go to of I0 comma star. So we are applying go to function on this one. So this dot is moving one position to the right. Then the productions becomes L production with star dot capital R. Okay, so here the look ahead equal or dollar can be written as, say, as it is. Then after the dot we have a non-terminal capital R. Then we have to include the productions of capital R. So how many productions in the grammar we are having the capital R? So we are only one production, we are having only one production after dot capital R. So we are including this production to the grammar. Okay, so the production becomes, so R is production with dot L. So we have to calculate the look ahead of this one. So how to calculate the look ahead of this one? So we are considering this statement, and we are calculating the look ahead. So we are considering L is production with star dot capital R. So after the dot we are having the non-terminal capital R, then include the production of capital R. And after R, is there any terminal or non-terminal? There is no terminal and there is no non-terminal. So we have to calculate the first half this one. So here the first half equal to R dollar. So equal to is a terminal and dollar is a Then first half equal to R dollar becomes equal to R dollar. So we are writing equal to R dollar in this one. Okay. Then, so considering this production, after the dot, we have a non-terminal capital L. We have a non-terminal capital L. Then include the productions of capital L. So what are the productions of capital L? L is production with dot star capital R, and L is production with dot ID. So then we have to calculate the look ahead of these two. Then we are considering this production. So here R is production with dot L comma equal to R dollar. Then the first half equal to R dollar, already calculating equal to R dollar becomes first half equal to R dollar becomes equal to R dollar. Then include the look ahead to these two productions. Okay, is there any doubt here? Anyone?
No doubt? No, sir.
Right. Then we are completing go to of I naught comma star. Then we are applying go to of ID. So I naught comma ID. So I naught ID is the terminal. Then we are calculating go to of I naught comma ID. So here L is production with, so we are applying go to function. This dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes L is production with ID dot, and we are adding the look ahead equal to our dollar to the same as it is. We are writing equal to our dollar look ahead same as it is. Then I4 state is completed. Then we are adding the new state for this one, this production. So I5. So here after the dot, there is no terminal or no non-terminal. Then no need to add another production. So apply productions add cheyadaniki ledhu. Why? Because dot tarvata terminal gaani non-terminal gaani ledhu kabatti we have to leave. Okay. Then we are naming the state as I5. Then we are completing go to function on I0 totally. We are completing go to of S is completed, and go to of L is completed, and go to of R is completed, and go to of star is completed, and go to of ID is completed. Then after calculating the go to of I naught with all terminals and non-terminals, then we are calculating the I1 state. So go to of I1 state. So is there any production? So it is a final production. So in this final production, there is no need to apply the go to function. Why? Because the dot is becomes the right end of the production. So no need to apply the go to function on I1. Then here also I2. So we are applying go to of this one. So here after the dot, we have a terminal equal. Then apply the go to of I2 comma equal. So here go to of I2 comma equal. So we are applying go to function. This dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes S is production with L equal to dot R. L equal to dot R, and the look ahead is dollar. Then we are writing as it is here. So here after the dot we are having a non-terminal capital R. We are having a non-terminal capital R. Then include the productions of capital R. So what are the productions of capital R? We are having only one production. So that production is added to the this one. So capital R is production with dot L. So here after the dot, we are having non-terminal capital R. Then include the production. So after R, is there any terminal or non-terminal? No, there is no terminal or there is no non-terminal. Then we have to calculate the first half epsilon into dollar. So first half epsilon into dollar becomes first half dollar. So first half dollar is dollar. So then we are adding the dollar here. Okay. So here after the dot, we are having a non-terminal capital L. We are having the non-terminal capital L. Then we are adding the productions of capital L. So what are the productions of capital L? So L is production with dot star R, and L is production with dot ID. Okay. So dot star R dot ID. So we are calculating the look ahead for these two productions. So we are considering this production. So after the dot, we have a non-terminal capital L. Then include the production. after L, there is no terminal or there is no non-terminal. Then we have to calculate the first half of this one. So first half epsilon into dollar is becomes first half dollar. So then add the first half dollar is dollar. Then add the look ahead of this one. So we are calculating. So here after the dot, we have a star. There is no productions with a star. And after the dot, we have an ID. So there is no productions after there is no productions with ID. So the no need to include the productions. Then so I5 state is completed. These productions we are having the different. So in this production, it is considering L is production with no this one. So there is no productions in this one. So we have to name the new state name. So that is I6. Okay. Then so after in I2 dot equal is completed. Then here after the dot we have a final production. So no need to apply on this one. No need to apply on this one. Then I2 is completed. Then we are applying the go to one I3. So in this I3, so it is a final production. No need to apply the go to one this one. So coming to I4. So we are applying I4. Go to of I4 with capital R, with capital L, with capital with star and with ID. So we are applying go to of I4 comma capital R. So what is the go to of I4 comma capital R? So this dot is moving one position to the right. Then we are applying go to function. So here go to of I4 comma capital R. Go to of I4 comma capital R. So then the production becomes L is production with star R dot. So this dot is moving one position to the right. Then what is the look ahead? Equal to R dollar. Equal to R dollar. So we are writing as it is into the production. Then after the dot we have, there is no non-terminal, there is no terminal. So no need to extend the this production. So we are naming the after I6 is completed. So I7 is we are having the state name, new state name for this production. Then we are applying go to of I4 comma L. So here go to of I4 comma L. So we are applying go to of after the dot. So this dot is moving one position to the right. So production becomes R is production with L dot. So what are the look ahead? Equal to R dollar. We are writing as it is onto the this one. So I7 state is completed. So we are naming the new state name I8. Then we are applying I4 comma star. So I4 comma star, we are applying I4 comma star. So this production becomes L is production with this dot is moving one position to the right. We are applying go to function. Then the production becomes L is production with star dot R and look ahead is equal to R dollar. We are placing same equal to R dollar. So after the dot, we have a non-terminal capital R. Then adding the production of capital R, the production is R is production with dot L. So we have to calculate the look ahead of this production. So we are considering this one. After the dot, we are having non-terminal capital R. Then include the production closure property, closure function. And after R, is there any terminal or non-terminal? There is no terminal and there is no non-terminal. Then we have to calculate the first half this one. So first half equal to R dollar becomes equal to R dollar. So we are writing equal to R dollar. Here then after the dot we have a terminal non-terminal capital L. Then include the productions of capital L. So L is production with dot star R and L is production with dot ID. So we have to calculate the look ahead for these two productions. So we are considering this statement. After the dot we have a non-terminal L. Then include the production. After L there is no terminal or non-terminal, then the first half equal to R dollar becomes equal to R dollar. So then include these two productions. So here these productions is equals to the state I4. So L is production with star dot R, and look ahead is also same. For example, in this production, the look ahead is only dollar, and here the look ahead is equal to R rather, equal to R dollar. So at that situation, we have to name the different name for this one. So here I4, the look ahead is also same for these productions and these two products, these productions. Then we have to name the same name to the particular state. So I4 is equal to I4. Then we are specifying the existing state name to this particular production. Then we are applying go to of dot go to of id. So go to of I4 comma id. So the production becomes L is production with, so we are applying go to, the dot is moving one position to the right. Then the production becomes L is production with ID dot, and look ahead is equal to our dollar. We are writing as it is. So in this production is existed in the I5 state. So we are naming the same name to the particular production. So I5 is existing state. So we are naming I5. Then, so I4 is completed. So next we are applying the go to on I5. So considering I5 state, so it is a final production. So no need to apply the go to function. Why? Because that dot is moving right end of the production. So no need to apply the go to function. So considering I6. So here we are applying the go to on I6. So go to off, after dot we have a capital R. Then then we are performing the go to of I6 comma capital R. Then the production becomes, we are applying go to function, this dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes S is production with L equal to R dot, and dollar is a look ahead. Then we are writing as it is. Okay, so here after the dot there is no terminal or there is no non-terminal. No need to expand this one. So this production is existed in the previous. So there is no here S is production. S is so the, there is no production in this one. So we are naming the new state name to the particular production. So this production is I8 is completed, and we are adding the new name, that is I9. So then we are applying the go to of I6 comma L. So go to of I6 comma capital L. Then we are applying go to function on this one. So this dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes R production with L dot, and dollar is the look ahead. So we are writing look ahead as is. So in this one, is there any production with R is production with L dot? R is production with L dot. So here there is no production with R is production with L dot. So we are naming the different state name, that is I10. Okay.
Then I2 lo only.
E production kuda undal ga. So total productions untene idi mottaanni I2 teesukunnam kada. Only one production kada. Adi mottham total productions ni manam mottham ee state kinda teesukundi. Okay. So we are naming the state is I10. Then go to off, so dot L is completed, and star we are having. So go to off I6 comma star, go to off okay. So screen kanipistunda, go to off I6 comma star, right? Go to of I6 comma star. So here I6, we are applying the go to function. This star is this dot is moving one position to the right. So the production becomes L is production with so star dot capital R. Okay. So look ahead is dollar. Then we are facing as it is. Then we are after the dot we have a non-terminal capital R. Then we include the production. Capital R is production with dot L. So we are calculating the look ahead. So after R, there is no terminal or no non-terminal. Then calculate the first half of dollar. So first half dollar becomes dollar. So then we are adding dollar here. And after the dot, we have a capital L is the non-terminal. Then you add the productions of capital L. So L is production with dot star R and L is production with dot ID. So these two productions are included. And how to calculate the look ahead. So after dot we have L, we are adding L production. And after L, is there any terminal or non-terminal? There is no terminal, there is no non-terminal. Then first half dollar is first half dollar is dollar, then add the dollar. So is there any productions in the previous existing? So here L is production with star dot R, R is production with dot L, and L is production with dot star R, and L is production with dot ID. But the look ahead is here equal to our dollar, but here only dollar. So these two are different. So then we are naming the new state name, that is I10 is completed. Then we are specifying the state name is I11. Okay, then we are applying the go to of ID. So go to of I6 comma ID. So L is production with dot is moving one position to the right, then the production becomes L is production with ID dot, and dollar is the look ahead. So we are adding look ahead is here, and so this is the L is production with ID. So here the look ahead is equal to our dollar, but here is only dollar. Then we are specifying the new state name to this particular one. So I12 we are naming the next name, next state name. Then here I6 is completed. Then we are applying the go to on I7. So in this I7 state, so this is the final production. No need to apply the go to I8. So here also final production. No need to apply the go to on I8. I4 already completed. I4 and I5 already complete. Already it is a final item. I9. So it is also final item. And I10. So it is also final item. And I11. So I11. So we are applying the go to on I11. So we are applying go to on I11. So this dot is moving one position to the right. So we are applying go to on I11. So I11 here is here. I11 comma capital R. So this dot is moving one position to the right. Then the production becomes L is production with star R dot comma dollar. So is there any production with the previous existing? So there is no production in this one. So we can specify the different name, different state name, new state name for this one. So I12 is completed. We are naming the I13. Okay. Then go to of I11 comma capital L. So we are applying this one. So this dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes R is production with L dot and dollar is the look ahead. So here I10 is same with where is same with dollar. Then we are specifying the same name to the state name. Then go to of I11 comma star. So go to of I11 comma star. This production becomes this dot is moving one position to the right. The productions are L is production with star dot R comma dollar. And after the dot we have a non-terminal capital R. So R is production with dot L, and after the dot we have a non-terminal capital L. Then add the production. So this production is equals to the same I11. So we are specifying the same state name to this particular one. Then we are applying the go to of I11 comma ID. So go to of I11 comma ID. The production becomes L is production with ID dot. So dollar is the symbol, look ahead symbol. So this state is I12. So I12 is same as the this one. So we are naming the same name to this particular one. So next I11 is completed total, and we are applying the go to of I12. So already it is a final item. Then no need to apply go to I13. So it is final item. No need to apply the go to function. So I10 already. It is a final item, I11. So already calculating the go to on I11. So there is no new states. We are calculating the go to function. So this is the calculating of LR of one items. Is there any doubt with this one? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Right. Then we have to find the final items in this one. So in this one, I in the state I not, is there any final item? The there is no final items on I not. Then we are considering I one. So this is the final item. We are writing I one s dash is production with s dot comma look ahead dollar. And this this one I two state, is there any final item? Yes, we are having one final item in this one. So I two is production with, so R is production with L dot comma dollar. So look ahead is say dollar. Then I three state, it is a final item we are writing. And in this I four state, we are not having any final item. Then I five, so it is a final item, then include. And I six, there is no final item, there no need to include. I seven, it is a final item, then include. Go to I eight, it is a final item, then include. I nine state, so I four state, there is no final items here, so no need to include that one. So I already include the I five state, and I nine, so it is a final item, then include I nine. And I ten, it is a final item, we are including. And I 11, there is no final items in I 11. And I 12, so it is a final item, then include I 12. And I 13, it is a final item, then include here. So there is in this one there is no final item. So here I 11, there is no final items. I 12 already included I 12. So these are the final items. So then we have to calculating augmented grammar. First one, find the augmented grammar, and second step, it is a calculating of LR of one item. LR of one items. And third step is we have to calculate, we have to construct the LR CLR parsing table. Okay, so we are constructing CLR parsing table. Here is here is the construction of CLR parsing table. So how to construct the parsing table? By using the go to function. So we have to fill these two, and we are filling these blanks. Okay, so here, so go to of I naught comma capital S. So I naught comma capital S is a non terminal, then the state is I one. So we are specifying the state number onto the table. So go to I naught. So we are specifying total states in the rows. So we are having 14 states. So 0 to 13. So we are specifying the rows. And 0th state, we are having the go to function with capital S. So it is having the state I1. So we are specifying 0s. We are specifying 1. Next, go to of I naught comma capital L. So in the 0th row, so we are having non-terminal capital L. So state is 2. So we are specifying state 2 here. And here, go to of I naught comma capital R. So I naught 0th row, we are having the non-terminal capital R. So that is 3. So we are specifying 3 here. Okay, then so in the CLR parsing table or SLR parsing table, we are having the rows with the state numbers, and we are having columns with action and go to function. So action means we are having the terminals, and go to function we are having the non terminals. So in this one, go to of I naught comma star, so it is a terminal. So we have to specify the terminal, we are having the shift operation. So I naught comma star with I four, so we are specifying S four onto the star in 0th row. Then we are specifying 0th row with star four, so I four is here. So we are specifying the shift operation with on terminal. So S four is specifying. Then
sir, దీంట్లో DFA construction ఉండదా సార్
ఏంటమ్మా కన్స్ట్రక్షన్
DFA construction
ఏదైనా చేసుకోవచ్చు ఆ స్టెప్ రాసుకోవచ్చు ఇబ్బంది ఏం లేదు ఫైవ్ స్టెప్స్ వస్తాయి సేమ్ SLR CLR LALR మొత్తం అన్ని ఒకటే స్టెప్స్ ఫస్ట్ ఏమో ఎస్ఎల్ఆర్ లో ఏం చెప్పామంటే ఆర్గ్యుమెంటెడ్ గ్రామర్ చెప్పము, కానీ ఆర్గ్యుమెంటెడ్ గ్రామర్ ఒక స్టెప్ కింద ఉంటుంది. సెకండ్ వచ్చేసి క్యాలిక్యులేటింగ్ కెనానికల్ కలెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎల్ఆర్ ఆఫ్ జీరో ఐటమ్స్, నెక్స్ట్ డిజైన్ ఫైనట్ ఆటోమేటా. సో సేమ్ ఇక్కడ కూడా సిఎల్ఆర్ లో కూడా ఫస్ట్ స్టెప్ వచ్చేసి ఆర్గ్యుమెంటెడ్ గ్రామర్, సెకండ్ వన్ ఎల్ఆర్ ఆఫ్ వన్ ఐటమ్స్ అనుకుంటాం, థర్డ్ స్టెప్ డిజైన్ ఆఫ్ ఫైనట్ ఆటోమేటా, అండ్ ఫోర్త్ స్టెప్ వచ్చి థర్డ్ వచ్చేసి డిజైన్ ఆఫ్ ఫైనట్ ఆటోమేటా, ఫోర్త్ వచ్చేసి పార్సింగ్ టేబుల్, ఫిఫ్త్ వచ్చేసి పార్సింగ్ ఇన్పుట్. సో ఏదైనా రాసుకోవచ్చు, ఇబ్బంది ఏం లేదు. ఫైనట్ ఆటోమేటా డిజైన్ చేయడం అంటే ఏం లేదు, స్టేట్స్ అన్నిటిని విత్ టెర్మినల్తో ఎలా వెళ్తుంది, నాన్ టెర్మినల్తో ఎలా వెళ్తుందో రాసుకుంటాం అంటే. ఓకే, సో నో
చేంజ్.
ఓకే, సిఎల్ఆర్ ఎస్ఎల్ఆర్ బోత్ ఆర్ సేమ్. సో కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఆఫ్ పార్సింగ్ టేబుల్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్. సో కెనానికల్ ఎల్ఆర్ ఆఫ్ జీరో ఐటమ్స్ టు ఎల్ఆర్ ఆఫ్ వన్ ఐటమ్స్, సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ డిఫరెన్స్. ఓకే, సో దెన్ గో టు ఆఫ్ ఐ నాట్ కామా ఐడి, సో దట్ ఈస్ 5. సో వీఆర్ స్పెసిఫైయింగ్ ఇన్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ టెర్మినల్స్, దెన్ we are using the shift operation. So S5 on ID. Okay. So here in the 0th row ID, so we are using S5. Then next, go to of I2 comma equal. So I2 is the second row and we are using the equal. It is a terminal. So then I6. So we are specifying the shift operation. S6 on equal with the second row. So here second row equal, we are using S6. Then next go to of I4 comma capital R. So I4 is the fourth row and R is the non-terminal, so I7. So we are specifying the number 7 on capital R in the fourth row. Okay, capital R. So in the fourth row, we are having capital R, that is 7. Then capital L. So I4 comma capital L, so that is I8. So we are specifying the number 8 on fourth row with non-terminal capital L. So non-terminal capital L, we are specifying the number 8. Then so here I4 comma star, so I4. So I4 comma the fourth row with star. Star is a terminal, so we are specifying the shift operation. Yes, 4 onto numbers fourth row. Okay, so in the fourth row we are having star S4 and id. So in I4 comma id, so this is I5. So shift 5 we are using fourth row we are using shift 5. Then I4 is completed. So go to off I6 comma capital R. So in the sixth row, we have a non-terminal capital R, then 9. So we are specifying 9 onto the table. So here 9 we are specifying, sixth row. So 9 and capital L, we are having 10. So that is, so go to of I6 comma capital L, that is 10. So we are specifying the number 10 onto the table. Then go to of I6 comma star. Star is a terminal. Then so we are having I11, so that becomes shift 11. So S11 is placed in the sixth row with dollar with star, so that is sixth row with star I11. And so here I6 comma ID, so it is I12. So 12 is shift 12 is placed. Why? Because ID is a terminal. Then the table, so S12 is placed in ID row. Then next go to of I11 comma capital R. So in the 11th row we are having non-terminal capital R, so we are saying 13 on the table. So 13 on the table, so with capital R with 11th row. Then go to of I11 comma capital L. I11 comma capital L is so I10. So we are specifying this number onto the table, so that the table becomes 10 onto the capital L in the 11th row. Then go to of I11 comma star. So star is the terminal, so we are using shift operation, that is S11 onto the star. So we are specifying S11 onto the star. Then go to off id i11 comma id. So we are specifying yes shift 12 onto id. So shift 12 onto id. So we are specifying in the 11th, right? Then go to off. So go to function is completed. So we are filling the table here. So with state numbers and shift operation. So how to write reduce operation. So we are considering the final items. We are considering the final items and we are filling the reduce operation. So before going to write this onto the table, so we are considering the grammar is here. S dash is production with capital S and S is production with L equals to R and S is production with capital R and L is production with star R and L is production with ID and R is production with L. So we are naming the specifying the state names to this particular grammar. Then what is the final item? First final item. So in the state I1. So here I1, I0 comma capital S. So I1 state. So it is the added production. So with the dollar, so we are adding accepted. So in previous class we are discussing in the first row at the dollar column we are having the accepted. We are having accepted. 1 minute. Okay, here is the final item. So in the first state, so first row, and we are placing the dollar, we are accepted. So in every SLR, PLR or LLR, we are having in the zero first row, and we are having dollar. So that is accepted state. Okay, then so next final item is I2. So what is the production number here? R is production with L. Sorry. R is production with L. So here R is production with L, that is fifth production. So then we are specifying R5 onto second row with dollar. Why? Because dollar is the look ahead. Okay, all of you understand? Dollar is the look ahead. Then we are placing R6 onto the state in the row second. Okay, so R5 onto the state with second row, we are saying the dollar is R5. Then what is the next final production? So final production is S is production with capital R dot. So in the third row, so S is production with capital R. So what is the production number here? So the looked is dollar. Then we are specifying S is production with R is in the state name 2. So production number 2, we are using R2 on particular state 3. Okay, then next production is I5. So L is production with ID. So L is production with ID means 0, 1, 2, 3. So third R3, so we are specifying equal to and dollar. So in dollar and equal, we are specifying R. So R4 means L is production with ID is fourth one. And we are specifying R4. Then what is the next production? So in I7. So in the seventh row, L is production with dot star R. So this is the hard production. So we are specifying R3 on in the seventh row. We are equal to on dollar. We are specifying R3. Okay. So R3. So in the seventh row, we are specifying equal to on dollar is R3. Then so next production is I8. R is production with L. So this production is number five. Then in the eighth row and equal to on dollar, we are specifying R5. Okay, we are specifying in the eighth row R5 equal to $1. We are specifying R5. Then next one, the next one I9. So S is production with L equals to R. So this is the final production. So this product, this number is one. So we are specifying R1 in the ninth row. We are having dollar. In the ninth row, we are having dollar and R1 is the production number. So why? Because S is production with L equals to R is the first production. Okay, so we are specifying R1. Then next production is I10. So R is production with L dot. So this production is 5. So R5 in the 10th row, yet dollar, we are specifying R5. So we are specifying R5. Then next I12, so L is production with ID, so this is the fourth one. So R4 we are specifying at the 12th row and dollar for specifying R4. So what is the next production? So 13 is the next production. L is production with star R dot. So here this production number is 3. So we are specifying R3 on 13th row, dollar is R3. Okay, so R3. So this is the construction of CLR parsing table. Is there any doubt with this one? Anyone? Any doubt? So there is no doubt. Then we have to move the next step. Then step 4. We have to parse the input string. The string is ID equals to ID. So in SLR parsing input string and CLR parsing input string and LALR parsing input string, both those three are same as the parsing of input string. So we are considering the three columns. So first one is stack and second one is the input string and third one is the action. So here initially stack consists of dollar at the bottom of the stack, then add the starting state number, so that is zero. So any parsing table, so it consists of zero is the starting one. So we are adding this one. So we are pushing zero onto the stack, then ID. So zero ID. So we are specifying zero ID. So we are performing the operation is shift file. So shift file action is a shift file. So we are performing shift action. First we have to push this input string and the state number to the stack. Okay, then ID is pushed into the stack and 5 is pushed into stack. Then 5, then ID is pushed into the stack. The remaining stack string is equal to ID dollar. So 5 equal. So in the state of 5 and equal, we are performing the reduce operation. So reduce 4. So reduce 4. So what is the fourth production? L is production with ID. So in the right hand side, we have only one symbol. Then we have to pop topmost two symbols. So ID and 5 is popped. Then dollar 0. Then so left hand side is L. Then left hand side is L. So we are moving L. So here 0 is the state. So 0 L. So L 2. So L 2 is placed. Why? Because the left hand non-terminal is L. So here 0 0 and capital L 2 is specified. Okay, 2 means so here the number. Okay, so 2 equal, then we are having 2 equal. So state 2 equal S6, shift 6. So shift 6. So then we are performing shift operation. This is pushed into stack and the number is pushed it into stack. So dollar 0 L2 equal is pushed it into stack and 6 is pushed it into stack. Then we are considering 6 ID. So 6th row we are having ID, so that is shift to 12. So we are performing the shift operation. Then we are pushing ID onto the stack and number onto the stack. So ID is pushed and 12 is pushed. Then $12. So in the row $12, we are performing the reduce operation. So reduce 4. So reduce 4 means what is the 4th production? L is production with ID. So here ID is only one symbol in the right hand side. Then we have to pop topmost two elements. So ID 12 is popped. Then the remaining is $0L2=6. Okay. Then what is the left side non-terminal? Capital L. And here 6. In the 6th row, capital L. So that is 10. Okay. So we are pushing this one. So L 10. Then $10. So in the 10th row, and dollar is reduced. So reduce 5. So reduce 5 means what is the 5th production? Capital R is production with capital L. So in the right hand side. So L is in the right hand side. L is in the right hand side, only one symbol. Then we have to pop topmost two elements. Then L and 10 is popped here. Okay, so we are popping. The remaining is $0L2=6. Okay, then in the right hand side, left hand side, we have a non-terminal capital R. Then push into the stack. So sixth row and capital R. That is number is 9. So we are having 9. So we are considering $9. So in the row, 9th row and dollar, we are having the reduce operation 1. So reduce 1. So one production is S is production with L equals to capital R. So in the right hand side we have 3 symbols. Then we have to pop topmost to 6 elements. So this one is 1, this 2, and this 6. So finally $0. In the right hand side, we have a non-terminal capital S. Then S is in the 0th row, S 1. So S 1. So $1. So here first row and dollar, we are having the accepted. So the given string is accepted by the given grammar. Okay, so we are constructing CLR parsing table. So is there any doubt with this one? Step 4. So in the same way, SLR parsing and CLR parsing and LALR parsing, the parsing input string is same. Okay, the differences is construction of parsing table and calculating of LR of 0 items or LR of 1 item. Is there any doubt with this one? Another example of CLR parsing. No doubt or any doubt?